G'day Ziggity here. Patch 2.6 has buffed something like 100 old unique items, and a lot of things you might have considered vendor trash in the past could now be treasure. Here are 15 buffed uniques that you should definitely keep an eye out for. Some of these could end up being quite valuable, and some could well be worth building around. Buckle yourselves in, we're doing a list video. First up on the list, Auxium, a forgotten classic, has been made great once again. The base has been changed to a crystal belt, making it much more attractive for CI builds, and on top of that, the leech has been changed to attack damage, meaning physical, elemental, and chaos attack builds can all take advantage of it now. With weapon LE damage, added ES, and a solution for CI freeze and chill vulnerability, this is a very solid belt for CI attack builds. Up next on the list is Belt of the Deceiver. This is one of those vendor trash uniques that you probably just vended and never really looked twice at, but it's been given a new life's purpose as a very solid melee belt. The block penalty has been removed and the all resistance buffed, but most importantly is that new Intimidate effect. This will cause all nearby enemies to take 10% more damage from all sources. That's a juicy, straight up 10% more multiplier. With life, fizz damage, and reduced extra damage taken from enemy crits to prevent one-shots, this has become a very well-rounded belt for melee builds. Not to mention that it can be worn from as early as level 20. Speaking of melee, Slayer's just got some serious love with the crazy buffs to Carnage Heart. The reduced life and energy shield mod has been completely removed, in addition to two new added leech mods, increased damage while leeching and 50% life leech rate. Up to 56 all attributes, leech rate, 40% damage, and resists, Carnage Heart is an extremely solid amulet now. Just watch your FPS with that extra gore mod. Continuing with melee love, Dietus has gotten some new power. Well, I say some, but it's kind of a lot. The damage mods have been increased by 50%, giving it much more respectable DPS. The burning damage against chilled enemies has also been increased to 100% to boot. However, the more interesting change here is that Dietus in the offhand now just straight up chills enemies for 1 second. This mod is really interesting because normally you need to deal enough cold damage to get a duration higher than 300 milliseconds to chill a boss, but this seems to ignore that as it has a listed duration on the item. This could mean that you can perma-chill bosses just by attacking them. That's a 30% slow, guaranteed, a very nice defensive buff for Dietus users. Next up, we have Lehoop of All, which has always been kind of decent, though kind of rare, and somewhat forgotten. The ranges have been buffed from 10 to 20 for all of its mods to 10 to 30, so keep an eye out because a well-rolled hoop is an extremely solid ring and potentially quite attractive for just about any build. Now, Deceiver is not the only vendor trash belt that's gotten some love. Immortal Flesh was always a cool belt idea, but just unusable due to that minus 5 max all res. You just took way too much extra damage for it to be worth it. Well, in 2.6, that mod is changing to just reduced resistances, not minus max. The difference here is that you can easily make up for those lost resistances with other gear or passives. And then, you're left with a belt that gives you a ton of life and mana regen, and the extremely strong minus 40 to minus 50 fizz damage taken from attacks. Those of you guys who can remember the old Arctic Armor will know how strong this flat reduction can be, essentially making your flesh immortal to many smaller attacks. Hehe. For number 7, Quill Rain has hardly been unused. It's still the bow of choice for explosive arrow builds after all. Nonetheless, it's gotten some juicy buffs. Increased damage and reductions to the damage penalty have made it a very strong leveling bow as well now. On top of that, it's been given 2 mana gain on hit, which is huge for both leveling and potentially making non-blood magic based explosive arrow builds. This could kind of be done in the past, but that 2 mana gain on hit is going to be a big help for those sorts of builds. This could well make planning explosive arrow elementalists and the like much more flexible. Summoners are pretty hyped that zombies themselves have been buffed and given a new threshold jewel in this patch, but that is not all. Montreghoul's Grasp has been massively buffed. Instead of 2,000 zombie life, you're now getting a whopping 5,000. And in addition to that, the increased physical damage has been changed to a more multiplier, which is going to squeeze a lot of extra juice out of your passive tree minion damage. Now for this next one, I know area of effect spells have been hit pretty hard this patch and people don't really want to play them so much, but take some solace in Rhyme Gaze becoming a new powerhouse of early endgame ES spellcaster builds. Energy shield on this item has been buffed to around 300 with quality, and the concentrated effect support has hit level 20 instead of 15. In addition to that, the energy shield recharge penalty is now recharge rate instead of start delay, which is far more livable. This helm is a very solid early 5 link for starting out. This next one is a bit of an unknown factor for me, but it's definitely worth keeping an eye on. One of the most popular skin transfer uniques, but not really used, was Edge of Madness. And well, it might just be worth using now that it's been given an added 1-2 fizz damage per level. This might just be something to build around, or at the very least it could be a blast to level with. Either way, it's worth keeping an eye out for it if you're running those beyond League Stones. Speaking of League exclusives, Bereks Respite has become something else completely. It's been given a bunch more damage, but most shockingly and ignitingly, it's been given a Prolifon kill effect to all nearby enemies for both shock and ignites. This is definitely looking like one of those sorts of uniques that you could make some pretty crazy builds around. With its potential rarity and power, this could end up being quite valuable. Up next, for number 12, Marilene's Fallacy, or Marlene's Fallacy, or something like that, has had one simple change that might open it up to more builds. This crazy crit multi-neck was always restricted exclusively to like your Void Battery Assassins and Ice Spear builds, things with crazy crit capping. But now, it might see more use in your more conservative crit builds, as the non-crit strikes deal 40% less damage mod has been completely removed. This means that though you'll lose crit chance and gain a ton of crit multi, you won't be penalized for not having 90% plus crit chance. If you want crazy ignites or boss one-shot montages for YouTube, then this amulet will be for you. We're getting close to the end of this list with number 13, and we're getting some pretty insane buffs here now. How about that Terminus Est? This has always been an insane leveling weapon for getting into maps, but now you probably won't want to swap it out. It's been given a huge damage buff and a juicy local crit chance, bringing its base crit up to a potential 8.75%. What this means is that with that Frenzy Charge on crit mod, we're going to see a whole new breed of Flicker Strike builds made with this weapon. And even outside of Flicker builds, this is going to be extremely sought after for two-hander builds getting into endgame. The penultimate item on this list is probably my favorite, the buffed Brutus's Lead Sprinkler. Such a cool theme for an item, sadly relegated in the past to a decent low-level dueling weapon and a leveling weapon. Well, it's now a whole lot more. You guys remember that Hand of Wisdom in action from last League? Yeah, I think we remember that. Probably one of the most OP things added to the game in recent times. Well, this is the strength version of that. Brutus's torture device here now gains 2-4 fire damage to attacks per 10 strength. It's only slightly less average damage than Hand of Wisdom in action, and well, you won't be going CI with it, but this thing does have local crit. I think it'll end up being a little bit weaker than Hand of Wisdom in action overall, but that should still be very strong because that was crazy. On top of that, it's going to be super fun to make strength stacking life builds with this thing, potentially using that new Molten Strike Threshold Jewel that was revealed today. Definitely something that I want to get my hands on. Finally, coming in at number 15, we have the Gull. I had to list this as the last one on the list because it's just such a big unknown. This might only end up being like a cute item or something and not really that valuable, but there's also a very small chance that this ends up becoming the next Headhunter, so I had to have it here. The Gull is an old forgotten trash unique from Domination League, and you'll need to get it under the effects of Domination League stones if you want it to drop. The Gull now has a Create Lesser Shrine on kill. Yeah, what? I don't really know either, but the image is of a tiny shrine that I assume and hope you can pick up just by running over it. Hopefully you don't actually have to click on it. Apparently, as a bonus, some shrines will now be shared with your allies as well. So this helm could mean stacking a ton of shrine effects to super buff you and your allies. I mean, unless there's some sort of internal cooldown here, you're going to be spawning one of these shrines on every kill? Question mark? There's no way to know how this is going to turn out, but there's a chance here that this thing could be insane. As such, it had to go at the top of my list of uniques to look out for in 2.6 because someone's got to get their hands on this and try it out, and, well, the first people to do that could end up becoming very wealthy. Hopefully you guys have found this list interesting. There are a ton more uniques that have gone from trash to treasure in this patch. Is there something else that you're excited for that I missed? Let me know in the comments below. That's it for now. I'm Ziggy D, and thank you guys very much for watching.